Good morning, everyone. First of all, I'd like to thank Exchange for Media for organizing this event, India Brands Conclave. And thanks to Dr. Anurag Batra and to all of you for attending it here. The topic which we're going to discuss is about brands, all about brands today and tomorrow. It's a very wide topic, today and tomorrow. I mean, tomorrow is going to come and today covers what was there in the past and continues. And what I have to talk about is celebrating choice, delighting with experience, availability and value. It's a very wide topic, so it can be anything can be talked under this umbrella. All that which leads to making brands, continuing them in the minds of the customer from a recall perspective, and growing them for the future of business. From a Reliance, I've been told that you can make and you should make specific references to our company so that people know about it. But I guess everybody knows about our brands and its happy customers, all of you. I'm sure there will be nobody in this hall and anywhere who has not been associated with any of the Reliance brands in terms of bought or continuing to buy at some point or the other. But nonetheless, I will just say that how we think and how we believe and how we work for our customers and stakeholders, I'll just try to bring up some key points which are relevant for the discussion. Obviously, everybody is knowledgeable and knows. And Reliance Retail, we actually, in terms of organizing our businesses, we do specific formats and verticals. And those formats are living to the ethos of why they are formed. When I say format, it means what was mentioned about Reliance Smart. So with Reliance Smart is a superstore which actually deals in groceries and general merchandise and the day-to-day necessities of groceries in the value segment. We have Reliance Trends, which is the value segment apparel. We have Reliance Digital, which is in the electronics. Then we have our furniture chain, Urban Ladder. Then we have fashion and lifestyle is too deep for us in terms of being present in each of the particular class of the customer's requirements, right from the mass to the very, very premium. So where we have joint venture partnerships with name the international brand, Diesel, Paul & Shark, Brook Brothers, Steve Madden, Superdry, and the list can go on and on. And we have partnerships with Marks & Spencer. We have Hamley's in the toy segment. And in furniture, as I said, we have Urban Ladder. In the lingerie segment, we have Zivame, Clovia, Amante. So I can go on reciting the names of the brands and and online, of course, Ajio, Jio Mart, they are there. The key to it is why so many brands and what goes behind thinking like this. Why not have just one Amazon or one Walmart and bring everything under one? What we understand is that customers in India definitely differentiate between different necessities of theirs, and they need to identify their shopping need for that particular purpose and making it into different classifications and different shopping journeys makes it far more for purpose. It enables reach and scale in terms of reaching to different places with different formats, giving it in smaller modular situation. So for example, if somebody wants to shop electronics, they relate to a Reliance Digital shop instead of a very large, huge place, and then inside there is a digital offering somewhere. We believe that a digital store separately makes a lot of sense for the customer. It enables the real estate to be available for that particular unit, which is to the size and purpose. And nearby, you can have another trend store, you have a grocery store, and all of them give identity to the customer's recall and recollection. So that's the fundamental understanding behind making separate verticals and store formats as per the consumption basket. When it comes to joint ventures, there are specific what you call nuances of the particular brand which comes in from abroad. They need their identity, they have their ethos, and it cannot be mixed. A diesel will be in a premium place and it will not just go in any smaller place or town. Similarly, a small format which is in the mass, say 7-Eleven is one of our formats right now, and 7-Eleven will go in a anywhere which is a neighborhood convenience, and it will plonk in large numbers. Is what is our experience. So living up to the ethos of the format, just because it is under one umbrella doesn't mean that you can mix and match, is a very important takeaway when we say in terms of about brands. So living the brand and respecting the brand and its values is very important. That's what goes in segregation. Again, online also, if we mix up everything, there is a particular way of understanding. Yes, you mix up, and there the search is possible to do everything. But again, in that also, the categorization is extremely important. Otherwise, what is on the top really remains on the top, and where there is marketing happening, those sales will happen, and rest of it will not really reach the fruition what it is supposed to reach. As far as building brands of tomorrow, there are certain very important things which everybody will talk about, digital revolution and digital understanding of the customer and digitally reaching to the customers, AI, ML, and but all that is like what everybody does is relying on certain search capabilities of the large service provider, and no harm in naming Google, Facebook, and Meta. What they are providing inherently, the ability to market, and everybody plugs into that. But really, we believe that the winning comes from your own understanding of your universe of the customer. For a small D2C brand, it can be a very small universe of people whom they have really transacted with, or they are able to reach. Everybody doesn't open all the pin codes and just try to do with courier services. Otherwise, you end up earning to pay the delivery courier situation. But otherwise, it is extremely important that you understand your customer segment and really talk to them, communicate with them in the language which we have set for that particular brand. So D2C, when it comes, it looks a very, very lucrative scenario, but really it's very difficult for all those who are in that particular activity will understand that how difficult it is and how quickly the money blows up if you do wrong marketing and you're not knowing your customer. The sales conversion is the art which is very important to be mastered before really getting into the marketing in a big way. So somewhere or the other, when we say brands of today, tomorrow, and what needs to be done, I'll just quickly, I noted down some pointers, and there's a big thesis. It cannot be a 10-minute session, cannot do justice to that. But all these pointers in terms of having some uniqueness, some kind of left out space which we are trying to occupy is a very important consideration in making a brand. Just copying something where already there is a big crowd doesn't lead to anything. There has to be a price proposition. Everybody gets carried away in terms of giving discount if you're trying to do, but that discount really is a very short-lived one. If somebody else comes and gives a higher discount, people forget about it unless you have a really a good price proposition along with the recall of the product, which uniqueness you are bringing in. There is quality definitely at the base of it in terms of customer will not be fooled by just a fancy brand name or a marketing. They will understand the quality and recall based on the quality, what they have experienced. If anything is wrong in quality, definitely it will be very punished by the customer. And even for the established brands, there is newness which is very much required, otherwise a stale scenario. If we look at the, I mean, the classic example which can be very easily understood is about the cars. The best brands in the world also have to bring in newer models. They cannot continue with the old model, even though they'll change something on the shape, but it constantly keeps to be moving. Similarly, the products which are in the FMCG or the consumer space need to be constantly moving, and inherently we don't experience it, but the brands are doing it with some kind of a plus, extra, or some new, something is always written. So that's important even for very large brands to bring refreshing scenario. Maintaining ethos is extremely important. We can't just waver from just because the brand name is there, do everything. It kills the brand impression. If it's a premium brand, it has to be the premium scenario. I mean, there are certain things which we should not make mistakes when we are building brands and nurturing our brands for future. And as Anurag just said about sustainability, and really the people have become very conscious about the planet. So sustainability cannot be forgotten at the base of it. In terms of when we are doing marketing, it has to be connected with the stocks. Otherwise, we would have just done a huge amount of marketing and we don't have anything to supply. That money goes off. Really, the unit economics in terms of whatever we are selling has earning. People just spend money, but they forget that we are here for making profit. And choosing the right medium of communication is extremely important. Otherwise, also, it's really difficult in terms of making a situation. I'll give you just an example which we will all relate to in this hall just now. There was a channel, Masti, which was, we saw all Shah Rukh Khan, everybody, Amitabh Bachchan. Before this, how many people had known about the brand channel? I mean, can everybody raise their hand? They had known about Masti channel, and after seeing it here, how many people became aware that there is this Masti channel? So 1, 2, 3, 4, right? So after now, everybody in this hall knows about this Masti channel. So what exactly happened in the process is that localized basis, and this is for the mass channel, but I'm saying from a store perspective or a retail perspective, what really happened is a small audience really got to know about the subject with a limited reach. So what is most important is the catchment or the class of the customer. If they are all made aware in a very effective and low-cost manner, so it can be as low as a hoarding in the locality, but if it is done, then everybody understands, have you heard about the brand? Yes. Have you heard about the brand? So that's what, they may not shop at this point of time. I mean, My Boli was another next one actually, right? That's a Marathi situation, but we got to know that yes, it is there. So these kind of, you know, small situations, but the analyst community, the media community, they should at least somehow be, you know, whole ecosystem of these, you know, people who are really important should really be aware of your brand. Then quickly one can make a brand. Similarly, the customers in the locality or the relevant customers, and definitely using the right agency is extremely important. Everything we try to do on our own, it may be vision and concept we give, but definitely the right people who are doing it all the time is extremely important in terms of, and look, I mean, last thing I just want to, you know, close it by, the customer is very important. Looking at the customer feedback, understanding the customer feedback all the time, and being close to the customer, being open and, you know, modifying based on what is relevant comments. Everybody will have a comment if you ask, but really filtering it out and what matters is extremely important. We ourselves pushing things without understanding the customer, really, finally we are making everything for the customer and trying to reach to the customer. So I just told that I'll just you know, close my talk with this, but any Q&A, I need to stay back and just take any questions. So I'll be very happy. I am, you know, available just now. You can ask any questions if anybody would like to ask.
Yeah, hi, I'm Uday Mathur from Human Edge. You mentioned about learnings from global brands and understanding the Indian customer. When you get your catchment studies to understand what the Indian customer wants, My question is, how do you relate to the findings from the demographics versus the culture that eventually you get to see here? And second, when we are swayed very easily by discounts, how do you, once you have formulated a strategy, how do you then move to counter that competition discount and that side of the equation?
So I think the second question is very easy to answer. First, I'll answer that we don't get swayed with discounts. We give only customary whatever it is. So the whole, whoever are doing discounting, also the large organizations, it is a misnomer that, only they are doing discounting actually. So what happens is really the creation of the impulse in the mind of the customer by certain loss leader or a discounted item usually. I'm talking about those who understand and do it well actually. Otherwise, some people may only understand discounting is a way of life, then I cannot talk about them. But those who do it well, they really bring some loss leader and some kind of discounting on the item where there are already a huge margin available by way of a talk with the manufacturer who would like to promote. They are doing the investing in the brand or the product. So really it becomes a collaboration that there is this kind of money in the game. And that brings people on the platform, if it is an online platform or to the store. And thereafter, impulse takes over. So once you are, especially in a physical store, if you are entering a store, you never end up only buying that item which was advertised and which was shown as a discount. There is a lot more in the store which people just pick up on impulse, and a whole basket is full most of the time because the person already spent about 2-3 hours going to the place, and they are not just going for that 20 rupees, 50 rupees, 50% off on a discount scenario. So really that's the high-low game, what it is called in terms of the discounting. So we don't believe in discounting for loss and losing money. We are the most profitable company in the retail space. So that's the philosophy on not discounting and getting carried away because everybody is doing. There is end of season sale and all, which is customary, but that is actually money in that. Those are only mediums of reaching to the customer and factoring in what was already factored in kind of a margin earning. The other part of it is in terms of the catchment study, as you said. See, India is a very, very unique country where at every 200 kilometers, the preferences, the taste, the way of living, culture of the people keeps changing actually. So even in the place where we are, very easy to describe Mumbai, actually all of us are, large number of people will be from Mumbai, that what happens in the South Mumbai, what happens in, Bandra area, about the thought process of the customer, the class of the customer. So if we look at the shopping happening at Palladium, if we look at the shopping which is happening in the mall, say our new mall, JWD Jio World Drive, it's the second big mall. And then you go to the malls in Andheri and Navi Mumbai, Mumbai side, and then take it further to Vasai Virar and Palghar to the outskirts of Mumbai, Kalyan, Dombivali. It's not 200 kilometers, but really, if you look at just the catchments as they are changing, you would not put a very, very, a brand would not want to come and just sell something which is really not relevant to that catchment, right? So inherently, it is the study which happens, and otherwise, one learns with experience. You put in the products and 3 months, 6 months later, the product will become stale and out of manufacture date. And obviously it will get out. Then at that time, you have a choice to sit and think, let's look at now. Or you start well, that look at what is selling in the nearby stores and nearby shops of the same type, and understand the market research. Luckily, there are lots of agencies and people who are doing research. So doing the good homework in the beginning is how we understand and we do it. And this was Mumbai, but when you go to, say, even further, Buldhana, Satara, Yavatmal and all, you need to have really, really different product, which is their taste, actually. So that's very inevitable, but it's not so easy to do also. At the same time, when we want to do it, it can be done with very quick situation. It can be as simple as sending our few people. So what we usually do is, before a new store opens in a geography, 15 days, 1 month before, we hire the people and they go around in the catchment, and that's how we build the assortment. And we used to do it, from 2006 we are in retail now in India. So we used to do it in the earlier time. Now, of course, we have our own, stores everywhere. So we just have to multiply the same assortment and all. But effort is required for everything. And nowadays it's more important from an online perspective, because all PIN codes become open at all the time immediately. So really, which PIN code among the 19,000 PIN codes of India, really, what is happening is extremely the next step, which is our learnings every day, right? So to be successful, that's the question.
Good morning, sir. Great insights through your session. I have a simple question here. We spoke about sustainable brands. So when it comes to Reliance brand, what does it do when it comes to sustainable? Because when you say joint ventures of different brands coming together, do you analyze whether they have a sustainable approach? Can you just give us that idea?
Yeah, it is far easier when we say Reliance brands, which is the global brand, because from their perspective, they are, really, I would not say we are not conscious. We are, India has always been very conscious about, we are the pioneers about nature and our Ayurveda. All of those things are, our culture and our handicrafts and all are definitely, from ages. But when it comes in the current context of you're talking about the manufacturer brands and the, situation, what we experience is that they are already ahead in this thinking, and the whole concepts are coming in from a lot of, countries which are already thinking about sustainability and making laws which are very relevant for that. So when we look at, what is coming from the brand, there is already all of that, which comes in already inherently from what they are doing, recycled material usage, what they are, trying to think about, even the packaging for that matter, actually. International brand will immediately, even before the laws were made for the single-use plastic stringent, they already were in, paper and recycle and all of that, actually, and with the advisories of not being away, and inherently in the product, the material used is increasingly on the sustainable side, actually. So recycled, everybody, you will see that there is a whole ranges which are coming in from the recycled and which are easy to recycle scenario. So from their perspective, it is that, and India definitely, there is in the newer product development, everybody is extremely conscious about this is going to come. It's just, how much time is everybody's guess in which product segment, but definitely it is going to move in that direction much sooner than we all believe will happen. Okay, so thank you very much for giving me this opportunity to be here. Thank you.